I'm delighted to be here as usual after several years. Andy alluded to the number of years I've been here, and it's been quite a few. And I should say I started in 1978. So if you do the math, this is probably 43 field days I've been at. And they're all delightful, they're all good. I love the breakfast touch with Carl and the Hoverson group here. That makes all the difference in the world. We didn't used to have that when it was the Red River Valley Potatoes and Growers Association, but now it's the Northern Plains Potato Growers Association. And it's what, the 75th anniversary? Is that what I saw? Is that right? And well, we won't go there, but there's a coincidence in there somewhere. I was on my way up here this morning and it was raining and it was dark. And so I turned off the radio and I said, I'm gonna let my mind float for a while and just see what I'm gonna say when I get up here. And I was telling that to Donovan this morning, okay? He said, oh, that's interesting. You probably ran out of miles before you had a good thought, right? I'm not sure where to go with that, but I thought it was a good reaction on his part. Anyway, I'm a pathologist. I usually have bad news this year. There's good news. I'll just give a little update on what we've seen this year. No late blight. Of course, that's a duh, intuitive obviousity. It's been too hot and too dry. The only late blight's been on an organic farm in Ontario. And then there's been in one field in Wisconsin and then maybe down in South Carolina or Georgia on tomatoes, okay? So no late blight, that's good news. Nothing in our area. This rain isn't gonna bring the late blight to us because there's no inoculum around. So that's the good news. We also have been doing some testing for soft drop bacteria, blackleg soft drop bacteria. We've had several samples this year, several, maybe a dozen from North Dakota, Minnesota. They've all been pectobacterium, no dickey at all. And of the other samples we've gotten in from other locations, mostly west of the Mississippi, have all been pectobacterium as well. So it looks like the dickey is kind of subsiding a little bit. We're going back to the pecto for the gods of the soft drop bacteria. The other thing I want to mention, and you'll probably hear this 1,000 times during all of these presentations, is that because of the heat, there's going to be a lot of physiological disorders in potatoes. Not disease, but disorders. Things like hollow heart, black spot, brown spot, probably heat necrosis, misshapen tubers, the sugars are going to be out of kilter. So there's going to be that heat is really going to cause some problems with potatoes. So I think you all need to be aware of that. Of course, they're disorders, not diseases.